Good morning and welcome to today's International Space Station Update Hour. You're joining us here inside of the International Space Station Flight Control Room at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. Right now we're looking on as the Orbit 2 team is currently on console, monitoring all of their respective systems on board the orbiting laboratory. Today's team is being led by Flight Director Ron Spencer, there on the right, and next to him at the Capcom position, serving as the communication link between all the teams here on the ground and the astronauts up in space, is Anna Fisher. And those astronauts right now are the crew of Expedition 32, having been on board the station since May 16th. In the middle there is Russian cosmonaut and Expedition 32 commander Gennady Padalka. To the left, another Russian cosmonaut, Sergei Revin, on his first space flight. On the right there is NASA astronaut Joe Acaba on his second flight, a veteran of one shuttle mission, STS-119. So getting straight into the crew's day today, here we can see Acaba and some of the work he was doing in the Japanese experiment module with the SPHERES experiment. SPHERES standing for the Synchronized Position, Hold, Engage, and Reorient Experimental Satellites. They're those bowling ball-sized objects. You can see the orange one floating right there in the top middle of your screen that are controlled by different algorithms to help scientists test out different autonomous docking and rendezvous operations. And all of these satellites are self-contained and contain their own fuel sources and also electronics and computers inside. Along with that SPHERES experiment, he's been working on the hardware command panel for the HTV spacecraft. He did a checkout earlier today. That HTV is the unmanned cargo craft built by the Japanese space agency. It's scheduled to launch a little bit later this month on July 22nd and will be delivering approximately 4.6 tons of cargo to the International Space Station. One other task for Acaba today is doing a lens and battery swap on the Earth cam. Just one of the Earth observation experiments on board the International Space Station that allows students from around the country to control the camera and use it to document and take a look at different geological features across the planet using controls via the internet. Moving on, Commander Padalka immediately started his day today with a few sample taking activities for the Russian immuno experiment, which is looking to provide a better understanding for how the body's immune system is affected during long-duration missions in space, and also is increasing the understanding of the coupling between stress and the functioning of the immune system, which has direct relevance for people down here on Earth. He was also involved in some repair and recovery work on the Russian Vostok system, which is part of the atmosphere revitalization systems on board the International Space Station. It's been having a few issues, so he tested one of the vacuum pumps in it and found it was not working, so they're going to go ahead and replace that. And again, that Vostok is used to scrub carbon dioxide from the cabin atmosphere for these astronauts on board the station. Then our third and final Expedition 32 crew member right now, Sergei Revin, was assisting Padalka in taking some of those samples earlier today for immuno. It's also doing some cleaning work on the ventilation screens inside of the Russian Zarya module, cleaning out some of the interior panels and also a few panels on the gas liquid heat exchanger. It's also doing some routine maintenance on the Russian Electron system, which is one of the oxygen generation systems on board the International Space Station, which splits water apart and then pumps oxygen into the cabin atmosphere.